Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Little and Large Teleshow, starring Little and Large. And now meet the boy, Supersonic Sid, Eddie Large.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show once again. Welcome what to are the you show. Doing with that brush?
What are you doing with it?
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
I'm just cleaning up for you. All right.
I hate you, butler.
Jim lad! Ha-ha! Billy! I can tell he's the son of a pirate. He's got a sunken chest.
Oh, you're cool. Oh, you're cool.
Give me the brush off then, didn't I?
Oh, you're cool. Oh, you're cool.
What are you doing?
Looking for my roots.
Oh, dear. They don't like it up and getting memory. They don't like it up and down. Do they, Pikey?
No, no, Mum. My mum said I've got to wear a scarf. Getting memory, I have.
Stupid boy, Pike.
All that, will you?
Yes.
Well, you can't see him now, can you? Now you see him, now you don't. Go on, Supersonic. What? I've cleaned up for you, go on.
Have you finished?
Introduce the show, go on.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, as I was about
there
to say...
There I want...
Oh, that was Basil Brush, that.
Boom, boom.
I should have done that earlier, but I forgot. Sorry.
I was just about to tell the ladies and gentlemen...
What's the theme this week? Because you always have a fabulous theme, don't you? What
I
is
it
going to be this
say
week?
It, yes.
Go on. I love his themes. Go on.
The theme tonight is sport.
Steps forward in amazement.
Excuse me, backwards.
I know, but I thought I'd go forward tonight. I love sport, I do. My favourite sports programme, Charlie's Angels.
That's not a sports programme.
You have your sports and I'll have mine. Ooh, Sarah. Got a lovely smile. I wouldn't like to give her a bite of my apple. No, but I do. I love sport, I do. I watch all the sports programmes. Did you watch the Grand National? I love that.
Hannes Redrum now coming to the last fence. Hannes Redrum. Hannes up. Hannes over in Redrum. Hannes over to Peter O'Sullivan at Newmarket.
Well, Lady Chatterley is just ahead of the gamekeeper, and the gamekeeper is going to catch her up on Lady Chatterley, and Lady Chatterley refuses the water jump, and he's back to the studio and Henry Cooper.
Yeah, he's a good boy, this John Conte. He's a good boy, John Conte. All right, John.
Yeah, Henry, all right, I'm having a bit of dispute now. You know, Henry, I'm disappointed I've got a fight, the night that Liverpool are playing in the cup, you know what I mean? But I think Liverpool will win the cup. I think they'll give the other team the 0-1-2. Yeah, disagree. It's given me the best shave I've ever had.
Yeah. Good result, that. Margaret Thatcher had a good result.
We had a good result.
She did have a good result, didn't she, in that by-election,
oh,
yeah?
Oh, yes.
Oh, if they carry on like that, Labour will have to go to the country. I don't think there's many countries that have them, do you? Sorry.
Oh, well...
I'll have a tax demand this week. Mm-hmm. Do you know what?
What?
It was sport that brought us together, wasn't it?
True.
Yeah, because I went in the snooker hall, I choked his head before I realised it was him. What sport do you like, Supersonic?
Cricket.
Cricket, I thought you would, yeah. You've often been the bales, haven't you? No, but I like cricket. We've got the Australians here this year, haven't we?
That's
playing
true.
Cricket for the Ashes. All right, sport. How you doing, Blue? All right, Skippy? He was on talking about it, wasn't he, the night? England's cricket captain.
Was he?
Yeah, he said, I think we have a good chance to win this year. We have good chances. Thank you, Kiki.
Yeah. Does he talk like that?
Yeah, that's Tony Gregg. He's South African.
Oh. Yeah.
It's funny, that South African captain in England. Why can't they get a real Lancashire lad like Farouk Engineer? Farouk Engineer. It'd be great, that, wouldn't it, eh? A lot of stars interested in sport, you know.
Oh, yes.
Lol and Hardy were football fans.
Were they?
We supported Accrington, Stanley. And you know Glenn Campbell? When Glenn Campbell isn't making soup, he's out there. He's out there with his flag on the football field singing, I am a linesman for the county. Elton John's a big football fan, isn't he?
Yes.
He watches Watford every week sitting there in the stand singing, don't go breaking my heart! And his pal's a big fan, isn't he? A football fan. I want to say his name, you know what I mean. I am sailing. I am sailing home again across the sea.
Who's that?
Ronald Biggs. And talking about people getting away with things, what about Tony singing last week? Hey! Hey, did you see him singing last week, Tony?
Yeah.
Hey, what about that, eh?
I thought it was very good.
Well, it was. I wasn't saying anything different. It was very good. Very good, excellent.
In fact, I've had lots of letters saying how he sounded like Stevie Wonder.
Oh, I thought he sounded more like Golden Wonder.
Now, that wasn't nice.
No, I meant it was very crisp. It was very crisp, Tony.
Oh,
it
was?
It was good.
Hey?
Very good.
I know.
Good. Very good last week.
Yes.
Are you singing this week, Tony?
No, I'm not.
No.
The Muppets.
Okay then, Muppets, you came down and sang.
Animal.
Okay, animal.
They don't care, they don't.
What have you got to say about that, Tony?
In a minute.
Oh!
They're all doing that, aren't they?
I promise I won't do that this week.
Do what?
Minute.
Hey.
Can you imagine him in his next film, John Wayne? Man-a-man-a. Funny that one.
I hope you haven't got our next guest doing that.
No, I haven't. Hey, what a set he's built for. Come on, let me show him all. Yeah. He's done this, haven't you?
I hold me
see
on
what's on it. Yeah, good idea, all the L's. No. Why he's done this is because we're going to introduce the lovely Miss Lynn Paul. I've got a smashing idea for you tonight, Lynn. Because what I'd like you to do, I'd like you to start off like this and go, do you want to touch? Yeah! Do you want to touch? Yeah! Do you want to touch me there? Hey, hey, hey. Do you want to touch? Yeah! Do you want to touch? Yeah! Do you want to touch me there? Oh. I'd like you to finish like that. Is that all right, Lynn?
Yeah, that's fine, but I'm not singing that song. Sorry. Sorry.
No one told me that.
I told everybody else.
I told everybody else.
Creep, creep.
Lynn, tell him the song you're going to sing.
If everybody loved the same as you.
Ah, I'll introduce her. Ladies and gentlemen, the lovely Miss Lynn Paul.
Creep, creep.
I know.
If everybody loved the same as you, tell me how many people can honestly say they feel wanted. I guess I'm luckier than some. Somehow you make me feel that I'm one of a kind. You've done something to my heart and to my mind. This world would be full of joy and laughter, and every dream would soon come true if everybody loved.
When I was a lad, old Shep was above, over hills and meadows we'd stray. Just a boy and his dog, we were so full of fun. We grew up together that way. I remember the time at the old swimming hole, where I would have drowned beyond doubt. But old Shep was right there to the rescue.
Bone throw, throwball!
He jumped
Bone throw, throwball!
And then pulled me out. Though the years fast did roll, old Shep he grew old. His eyes were fast growing dim. Then one day the doctor looked at me and said, I can do no more for him, Jim. With hands that were trembling, I picked up my gun and aimed it at Shep's face. But I just couldn't do it. I wanted to run. I wish they would shoot me instead. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to start by saying...
Hey, you! Oh, look who it is, eh? Come here, you! I see you, Jim. Boom, you're great.
Do you want a drink?
No, you don't. All right. Hey, you are great. So you are. You're great, son. You're magic, Jimmy. You'll never guess what I'm doing here, eh?
Aye, so I am.
Oh, yeah, you're great, so yeah. You know what I've come on here for?
What?
Because come here when I'm talking to you. Oh, you're great, are you great? Do you want a drink?
No, all right.
Now, listen to me. Get your clogs on, mother. I'm on again, all right. Hey, listen to me. I think you're great. You don't want a drink? All right. Now, listen. Because them two idiots you've had on the last 2 weeks, they can't clog dance for toffee.
Clog dance?
No clog, clog. That's a clog, no a clog. What's the matter with you? Can you talk properly? You think he's great? Say any road up. Come here when I'm talking. You don't want anything, all right. Anyway, I'm going to show you how to do the Scottish clog dance, all right? Hey, Mr. Hatch, will you get that load of ruffians started up, please? Thank you very much. Here we go. See you next week. Ta-da, everybody. You're useless. Useless. You're useless. You're homeless. A lot of you.
Manamanap.
Who was that?
Another one of your cousins.
Not Jock Lad.
Yes.
Ah, he's great. See you, Jimmy.
He kept calling me Jimmy.
Calls his wife Jimmy. Do you like the jackets, folks, eh?
Amazing what you can get at these carpet sales. Do you know what? I'd like you to help me now, Supersonic, if you would be so kind as to help me, if you would. Would you help me, please?
Yes.
Yeah, good lad. Because what I'm going to do now, I'm going to describe to everybody a recent outing I had with our local birdwatching society.
You with a birdwatching society?
Yeah. I'm very interested in things like that.
You don't know the difference between a chaffinch and a blue tit.
You want to bet? No, because what I want you to do, I want you to do your bird impressions, you see, because they've never seen you do bird impressions. It'll be great, won't it? Will
this
you do it?
This is a silly idea for you to do your impressions, isn't it?
It isn't. I'm not going to do any impressions. You're doing impressions. I'm just telling the story. Go on, do it. You go on. You're great. Tony, can we have a little bit of background music, please? You'll be good at this.
It was a lovely summer evening. A dull red glow filled the sky.
The bingo wall was on fire.
A lone curlew flapped overhead.
That's brilliant, that, wasn't it?
As a keen birdwatcher, I cannot express my delight as Miss Turvey's hand gently brushed against my binoculars and adjusted my prism. Then I heard the call of the woodpecker. Was legless. He was Brahms and Liszt. He was out of his head. He'd been giving it plenty of air. I could tell this because he was trying to build a nest out of empty cider bottles. Just then, we heard the cry of the very rare redneck farmer. Who was whistling for his wife to come in and rinse his King Edwards under the tap. Then Mr. Welbygott, our respected leader of our group, all excited and red of face, said, "Here! Come over here, will ya? Look what I've found! I've just found one of your actual little elves, ain't I?"
I can't do an elf.
Just whistle, they'll never know the difference. I'm glad they give you that extra millet.
Just then, the village clock struck two.
I didn't know you could do a village clock.
The day was drawing to a close, and we saw the tiller of the soil wend his weary way home. As he got close to me, I suddenly recognised him. You'll never guess who it was.
Don't tell me.
It was Benny from Crossroads.
Because I was looking for Gaffer and Miss Diane. Because I like Miss Diane. Because Gaffer, he gonna employ man who tells stories about Tom Jones in paper. Because Gaffer say he biggest muck spreader in country. It's good, that, wasn't it? Thank you. Thank you. Good, that. Brilliant, that one.
That was another excuse for you to do your silly impressions, wasn't it? Don't start that.
I know someone who does good bird impressions.
Who?
Danny LaRue. In fact, our next guest impresses the birds.
Who's that?
It's the one and only Bernie Flint.
Hey, Bernie!
Hi, Bernie.
Hi, Bernie.
Hi, Bernie.
Great to see you.
Actually, Bernie, sorry about that. Bernie, ladies and gentlemen, it's our great pleasure because we've been asked to present you with this.
Hubcap of Sid Little's car.
Now, tell them what it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a silver disc for a quarter of a million sales of Bernie's record.
That's great, isn't it?
Well done, Bernie.
Bernie, is this... Is this the song? Is this the song you're going to sing tonight?
Aye, this is the song. I don't want to put a hold on you.
Well, off you go and get ready, old Shan.
You've forgotten something, fellas.
What's that?
Well, we're not spinning the drums, but the winning vote out.
Oh, hello, I will do the jokes. You sing the song. Go on. I bet you told him to say that, didn't you?
I never did, no.
It's been the rat and then the da, creep, creep. It's one of your mates, isn't it?
Have a look.
Smashing that, isn't it?
Oh, I wish I could get one.
You'll get one. You've only got to buy one record a week for 250,000 years. You'll get one. That's nice. So here he is, ladies and gentlemen, singing I Don't Want to Put a Hole on You, Bernie Flint.
you wanna leave me, well, that's alright. Come the morning, find you gone, well, I don't mind. It's not that I don't love you, baby, you know I do. I don't wanna put no hold on you. Such a lovely feeling, darling, having you so near. Gee, it's good to know that you're around. Should you ever go away, then let me make it clear, I won't ever try to tie you down. Well, that's alright. Find that you're in need of a change, you will, I don't mind. Don't misunderstand me, baby, my love is true. I don't wanna put no hold on you. Such a lovely feeling, darling, having you so near. It's good to know that you're around. Should you ever go away, then let me make it clear, I won't ever try to tie you down. And if you wanna leave me, well, that's alright. Come the morning, find you gone, girl, I don't. Not that I don't love you, baby, you know I do. I don't wanna put no hold on you. I don't wanna put no hold on you. I don't wanna put no hold on you. I don't wanna put no hold on you.
I'll never do it. I'm not as young as I used to be, no. Oh, I'm nearly 3 weeks old. Come on, little bottle.
Come on.
Oh, well done. Hey. Oh. Yeah, you're a good one. I'll do it now. Huh? Are we all right?
Come on.
Help me cross this. Oh, thanks, little bottle.
You're late again. Where have you been?
Hey, I've just come from watching a bloke keep 3 ferrets down his trousers for 205 minutes.
He didn't, did he?
Yeah, they're putting him in the Guinness Book of Records.
What as?
An idiot. Come out with some good ones, don't they?
Yeah, do that.
Hey, do you know what, as well? What? I buzzed through one of them tough comprehensive schools, the ones they're making all the fuss about.
Oh.
I went in the sixth form, and they were conducting a new revolutionary educational experiment.
What was that?
Learning to read and write. Who have I missed?
Bernie Flint.
Huh? Who?
Bernie Flint.
Oh, I thought he said Flit. He's good, isn't he?
Oh, he's 14 times.
Yeah, I know. Good-looking lad.
Oh, he's good, yes. The girls love him, you know.
I know they do. Mm. Hey, talking about that, good news for the trade union movement this week.
What's that?
All the bunny girls from the Playboy Club being allowed to join the union.
Have they?
Yeah. I had a buzz around to see what was going on. Can't wait for the first strike.
Why?
You know what the slogan is?
What?
One out, both out. There'll be some police volunteering for that demonstration, won't they, eh? They'd rather hold them up than the traffic.
Buzz.
London will be like a burglar's paradise. Hey, talking about burglars.
What?
See, Sir Harold Wilson had his house broken into, eh?
Never.
Ah, he stole some secret documents.
Ooh.
I went round there, you know.
Did you?
I think they got some Mary's poems as well.
Oh.
Sir Harold was cheering her up by reading one of his. It was good as well. He said,
Mary and I had a break-in. They burgled the outside shed. The police couldn't find who done it. I wonder if it was Ted.
Now look here, Harold.
Hey, did you watch This Is Your Life?
Oh, yes.
Lord Mountbatten.
Oh, it was lovely.
Brilliant.
Lovely.
It's the first time I've heard Eamon say, "Hello, sailor. This is your life, boy." Hey, let's do that programme.
Did it? Why?
It's the only This Is Your Life Arthur Askey hasn't been on. I am just a busy bee, a busy bee. Oh, what a glorious thing to be, how we grown up, busy bee. Ah, thank you, playmates. I like Arthur Askey.
He's good, isn't he?
I wonder if you'll be in this film I'm going to see.
What's that?
It's a new film. Oh,
is it?
Frightening it is. It's about a giant gorilla that terrorises a Chinese island with a combination of singing and karate.
What's it called?
It's called A Fling Flong with King Kong. It's a sing-song in Hong Kong. See you next week, Grasshopper.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tony Hatch and the Love Machine.
Face me. He won't be annoyed. I bet he's not annoyed.
All right, Ed.
Yeah, all right, Ed.
Weren't you annoyed when I did that?
Did what?
He won't be.
What's the matter, Ed?
What's the matter, Ed?
You're not annoyed, are you?
No.
I don't know. You've got no aggression, you haven't, Supersonic.
Who's your favourite? Kojak.
You never hear him say that, do you?
Are you all right, Cracker? Hey, Saperstein, will you go outside and get me a chip butty, please?
Doesn't say that, does he? Cracker! Saperstein! Get in here! Now, what have you got in common with Kojak?
Nothing.
You have, you're both singers.
Oh. If a picture paints a thousand words, why can't I paint you?
I don't know.
Your face ain't got no numbers on it.
Now then, see?
He's a nice bloke, but the reason he's a successful singer, because he's tough. Got the aggression, you see, and that's what you haven't got. Which brings me to my great plan. I'm going to toughen you up.
I don't want to be tough.
Do you trust me?
Yes.
You shouldn't trust anybody. I'm going to get a tough character on now, sort you out. Stay, hang on there. Come on, come on, come on. Here he is. Right, I want you to meet the one and only Mohammed Joey.
He's on, Elliot.
Get back! He'll have you through them bars, you've not been fed for a week. Whoa! He's seen them all off, you know. He's seen that Sylvester off.
I thought I tore a putty kid. Thopper and thopper that.
15 rounds with Henry Cooper, splashed him all over. Oh. And you know what? He's just come back from the North Sea.
Has he?
He helped that Texan to cap the oil, stop it from spouting all over. Jim Callahan's asked him, can he do the same thing to Wedgwood Ben?
Are you all right, budgie?
Do you know what?
What?
He has been insulting you on the bus.
Has he?
Oh, she acting out. Should have heard. That supersonic Sid, he ain't nothing but a kid. He looks just like Twiggy. I'm going to whoop him like Miss Piggy.
Bye!
Yes. So, honestly.
Oh, he has, has he?
Yeah, he has, he has.
Little been having yellow canary just looks like a fairy.
Hey, don't.
Two can play that game, you know.
Get off, get off, get off. No, stop it. Stop it. Now go to sleep, I'll get your milk in the morning.
The fight's off.
Why?
Why's the fight off? You're supposed to vanish now.
No, listen. The fight is off because we've had a telephone call from animal lovers. You're not going in the cage there. You're not going in the cage with that canary because they said they don't want to see a little animal get hurt.
It's only a canary.
It's not the canary they're worried about, it's you. Right, with your new aggression, introduce your next guest.
Ladies and gentlemen, our special guest stars all the way from America,
the fabulous Stylistics! Yeah, that's fabulous. Hey, what are you going to do for us at the end of the show, Supersonic?
I'm going to sing a country and western
song. Well, hot diggity dog, I thought you would. Right, you've got to look the part. There you are. The Milky Bars are on, Sid. Come on. What are you going to sing?
Sing me an old-fashioned song.
Well, why don't you, boy? Go on, here. Yeah! Right, I'll get them all clapping.
Sing me
Sing me an old-fashioned song.
I certainly will, that old chicken.
Bring me back to the time in my mind where my memories all come from.
You know more than one chord.
A good time and song, the kind that makes you want to sing along. A good old-fashioned hand clapping, knee slapping, foot tapping song.
You and Johnny Cash.
I keep a close watch on this friend of mine. He is so thin, he's sometimes very hard to find. He holds his pants up with a piece of twine. If you're a friend of mine, then put it twine.
Sing me an old-fashioned song. Time in my mind where my memories all come from.
Okay, this morning I had a pint of milk. Dinner time I had 4 bites more. Tea time I had 6 bites more. Now skip to the loo, my darling.
A good time and song, the kind that makes you want to sing along. A good old fashioned hand clapping, knee slapping, foot tapping.
Sing it nice, Sue.
Good night, folks.
Thank you.